So today I'm going to paint a radiator, and it is the most boring thing to do, and especially this radiator is in quite good condition. It's just got a few black bits here and here, but unfortunately I can't just paint those bits because then it won't be the same, so I'm going to have to do the whole thing. This is the most boring job to do. The first thing you've got to do is to make sure that you turn the radiator off. You can't obviously paint a warm radiator. So I've turned it off, I'm just waiting for it to cool down. While I'm waiting for it to cool down, I'm going to sand it. Now this is one of the old fashioned radiators. It's a four, is it called column?
That's a three column.
Four. So this is a four column, so it's a really nice radiator. But I can't possibly sand down each thing, so you just have to sand down what you can get to. So I shall do that now. Absolutely hate sanding down because you never know if you've done enough, but you could just go on and on and on, and also it plays havoc with your hands. My hands have been doing so much decorating in this flat that my hands are so dry. At night I'm smothering them in hand cream and I put white cotton gloves over the top before I go to sleep. I also wear a silk turban to bed, and my husband got in bed the other night and I got my turban and my white gloves, and he said, "Oh, you're going to do a magic trick for me." Okay, now I've got to clean it thoroughly. This is really important that you clean it properly, because all those bits of dust, if you don't get them out, when you spray it, it's going to seal the dust and it'll be a bumpy finish and it'll just look horrible. My brother used to varnish his floors all the time years ago, and he never used to sweep the floor first, and you'd just see all these mounds of dust with varnish over. So it's really important that you clean it thoroughly. I'm going to use a bottle brush to really get in there. The easiest way to do this really is to get your wet J cloth, poke it through to the other side, you see, and do like a few backwards and forwards and pull it through. Yeah, that's cleaning it really well. I've washed the radiator, I've rinsed the radiator, and I've left it to dry. I've also put newspaper behind it on the floor because this spray paint gets everywhere. It says using a well-ventilated room, but it is blowing a gale today, so I'm not opening the window because it'll blow the paint everywhere. So I'm just going to spray the radiator now. I'm using Ronseal Quick Drying Radiator Paint in white. Oh, that stinks, that really does stink. I need to get out of the room. I'm going to leave it to dry and recoat in 30 minutes.
OK.
Okay, I've left it 30 minutes and it's dry, it's touch dry. So I'm going to do the second coat now, and then you can't put the radiator on for 24 hours. I've never used the Ronseal one before and it absolutely stinks, which I always think is a good sign. I hate all the water-based paints that just don't smell at all. Right, so I'm going to do the second coat now. When you're spray painting, it's really important to keep moving the whole time and to not get too close, otherwise you'll see the paint start to run. Hi, it's a different day, but I've just popped back in here because I forgot to show you the finished radiator. So this is it. I'm really happy with how it's turned out. It's flawless. There you go. So, I hope you found my radiator painting video useful. I'm actually here today filming a different video about bleaching wooden work surfaces. So I'm quite looking forward to this one, because it's something I've never done before and I really want to see if it works. Okay, see you next time. Bye.